Welcome to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the Executive Chairman at Cerro De Pasco Resources, Steven Zadka. Steven, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
My pleasure. Now let's dive in and talk about the company. How does it specialize in mining and resource management, but particularly in Peru?
So Cerro De Pasco focuses on resource management and mining because we have a large tailings project in Cerro De Pasco, and our objective is to reprocess that and create jobs, a circular economy, and improve the livelihood of the population over there.
And how is that being accomplished with the Quiulacocha and Santander projects?
So Santander is a separate operation. It's a producing mine, and that basically gives us the ability to generate cash flow to support the business. In Peru, it's important to be a producing mining company, and Santander was an opportunity that came across our desks about 2 years ago, and it was a good entry point for us to begin, you know, becoming a producer in Peru. So Cerro De Pasco, the tailings project there is something that we've been working on for a long time. It's not in production yet. It requires support, from the government and the local community. And it's always important to have a stronger footprint in the country. So being a producer was a natural way forward for us.
And by the sounds of it, it looks like Quiulacocha has that government support and it's moving ahead to production. What can we expect to see from the company in the next few quarters in that project?
Now, that's right. You know, we've spent a long time emphasizing to the government the positives of reprocessing these tailings, the job creation, the tax generation. You know, these are old tailings circa 1908 to the late 90s, and they've been, you know, deposited into basically an unlined facility that no one ever thought of. You know, no one ever thought about the future consequences of doing something like that. And we just so happen to have special mineral rights over these tailings. So it's been taking a long time to explain to the government the benefits, but you know, they finally understand, and we're very happy about that. And the community's in full support. We just announced that we have we're on a special list that's administered by the Ministry of Economy and Finance, where there's only about 200 or 300 projects in the whole country which are on that list. And the objective is that they've identified this project as a high priority, you know, project for the country with a lot of positive impact. So that helps us in fast tracking, you know, everything that we need to do in order to get going. In the next few months, we expect to receive an easement to begin drilling the tailings. We were anticipating that we should be able to start drilling by the summer, and that will coincide with the dry season in Peru as well.
And Steven, the company received PEA results for the Santander project. What are those looking like?
Well, it's positive, which is good. And it focuses only on the main Santander pipe. It actually leaves out an important area of that pipe, which is called the upper zone. And that's highlighted in our presentation on the website. The PEA includes about 5 million tons from the main Santander pipe. And the upper zone, in fact, is the old mine workings, which contains a potential of 3 to 4 million tons at around 6% zinc. So while the PEA is positive and the IRR is good, you know, about 40% pre-tax and NPV around 70 million US with $2,800 long-term zinc, when you look at it in conjunction with the upper zone potential, that number would improve dramatically. And that's something that we'd like to highlight.
Sounds exciting. Thank you so much for stopping by and sharing these updates. We look forward to hearing more.
Thank you.
Again, the executive chairman at Cerro de Pasco Resources, Steven Zadka.